child, I remember my first exposure to Bond. Transporting you, taking you to this wonderful place with extreme situations. James Bond doesn't really like to look back. We know very little about his past. How did he end up being where he is and the way he is? Fleming put his own struggles on the page. This is 50 years now, and they've kept it going. It's unique within movie making. On a number of occasions, I think Bond would have died away, and we would have lost it. In the face of overwhelming odds, he finds a way.
When Bond came out, the world was very grey, it was black and white. Here you get this film, highly colourful, filled with flash and bang. It was an escapism, a chance to see great places and to leave their dreary lives.
You make the first, it works. In making the second, we knew we had something going. By Goldfinger, we had a cultural phenomenon.
It was absolutely magic, what was happening. There was screaming, there was yelling. You couldn't believe the audience reaction.
Champagne, adventure,
and all the sexual fantasies of the healthiest virile bachelor.
They were so transported by the magic that was Bond, they had a reaction completely out of self.
We started to play the picture 24 hours a day. That's how successful these Bond pictures were.
1963, Dallas, Texas, had been associated with the shooting of one man, President John F. Kennedy. All that changed in March 1980 when J.R. Ewing took this fictional bullet. A shot that was heard around the world.
The question which has swept the nation caused puzzlement, bewilderment, even anguish.
For one long summer, who shot J.R. was the question on everyone's lips.
J.R. has so many enemies that almost anyone could have done it. So who did?
It turned Dallas from a TV hit into a phenomenon. Mind his plums. And made Larry Hagman a worldwide superstar.
Everybody wants to know who shot you.
Mm-hmm. Even the Queen Mother.
£500,000 was bet on who done it. The first time money was ever placed on the outcome of a TV show in the UK.
At the betting shops, the supposedly dead Dusty, Sue Ellen's ex-lover, is the hot favourite at 6-4.
Even if they weren't betting, everyone was guessing.
Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around, and I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down. Hey, baby, there ain't no easy way out. Stand my ground, and I won't